In this video, we will solve a problem of voltage divider transistor biasing. Problem is, for the following circuit, draw the DC load line and determine the operating point. Assume silicon transistor. The circuit of this voltage divider biasing is shown in this figure. We have to find DC load line, we have to draw, and we have to calculate the operating point, that is zero signal collector current and collector to emitter voltage. We already know to solve the potential divider transistor biasing circuit, we draw its Thevenin equivalent circuit. And to draw the Thevenin equivalent circuit, we have to find the Thevenin equivalent voltage across base and ground and Thevenin resistance. The circuit of Thevenin equivalent of this problem is drawn here. In this circuit, we have to calculate the Thevenin voltage VB and Thevenin resistance RB. In the analysis of voltage divided transistor biasing, we have already discussed the Thevenin voltage can be given as VB equals VCC R2 upon R1 plus R2, and Thevenin resistance RB can be written as RB equals R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So we will put the values of R1 R2, and on solving this expression we can find the Thevenin resistance, whose value will be 3.33 into 10 to the power 3 ohm. Similarly, we will calculate the Thevenin voltage by writing the values of these quantities. Here VCC is the 15 volt, so put the value VCC 15 volt R2 upon R1 plus R2 and solve this. On solving, we will get VB equals 5 volt. So the Thevenin equivalent circuit we will draw like this, and we will use the values of VB equals 5 volt and RB equals 3.33 into 10 to the power 3 ohm in the analysis of this circuit. To draw DC load line, we have to write a relation between collected current IC and VC, and then using that relation we will find two point, one on collector to emitter voltage axis and another point on the collector current axis. So to write this relation, we will use KVL in the collector circuit or output circuit. So we can apply KVL in this way: VCC minus 0 equals IC multiplied by RC plus VCE plus IE into RE. So KVL equation can be written like this. Here VCC minus 0 equals IC RC plus VCE plus IE RE. Since base current is very less in comparison to the collector current, so we can ignore base current. If we ignore base current, then we can write VCC equals IC RC plus VCE plus IC RE. Now we will use this equation to find two point, one on the voltage axis and another on the current axis. To find the point on the voltage axis, we will put IC equals 0 in this equation. If we put IC equals 0, then VCC equals VCE. In this way, since the value of VCC is 15 volt, so we can write VCE equals 15 volt when collected current IC is 0. So this will be the point on voltage axis. Similarly, to find the point on current axis, we will write VCE equals 0 in this equation. If we put VCE equals 0, then IC will be, for VCE equals 0, IC will be VCC upon RC plus RE. Now write the values of VCC, RC and RE. In this way, we can calculate IC equals 5 milliampere. This 5 milliampere collected current is for VCE equals 0. At the point where VCE will be 0, the collected current will be 5 milliampere. Using these two points, we can draw the DC load line as shown in this figure. When collected current is 0, in that case, the collector to emitter voltage will be 15 volt. And at the point on current axis, when collector to emitter voltage is 0, in that case, collected current will be 5 milliampere. Now, by joining these two points, we can draw the DC load line. Now, we will calculate the operating point. Operating point means zero signal, collector current and collector to emitter voltage. For voltage divider biasing, emitter current is given as IE equals VB minus VBE upon RE. VB we have already calculated. VBE is base emitter voltage for silicon transistor, it is 0.7 volt. RE is given 2 kilo ohm. So write the values of this quantity. We can calculate IE as 2.15 milliampere. Since collector current IC is nearly equal to the emitter current, because base current is very less in comparison to the collector current and emitter current, so collector current can be given as equal to the emitter current, which is 2.15 milliampere. This is the zero signal collector current. Now, this collector current can also be written as ICQ, means collected current at the operating point. ICQ and IC both are same, and this is the zero signal collected current. Now, we will calculate the value of collected to emitter voltage for the collected current IC equals 2.15 milliampere. To find collector to emitter voltage, we will use the collector circuit and we will use the same relation which we have used to find the two points for the DC load line, and the equation was VCC equals ICRC plus RE plus VCE. On putting the values of these quantities, IC, RC plus RE and VCC, and solving this equation, we can write VCE equals 8.55 volt. In this way, we have calculated collector to emitter voltage as 8.55 volt and collector current as 2.15 milliampere. Now indicate these values on the DC load line, which will be the operating point. So here Q is the operating point where the collector to emitter voltage is 8.55 volt and collector current is 2.15 milliampere.